Good morning and welcome to another episode of Erasmus TV. Today we'll look to perhaps a brighter future, a future after this campus lockdown. And how will this 1.5 meter distance campus look like? What will be possible and what won't? We have here on, well, video phone, Marijke Weusting. She's director of real estate services and she's part of a committee that is investigating this new future for the university. But also here, chair of the executive board, Hans Smits.
Good morning.
Good morning. And to start with you, last Tuesday we all heard most measures against corona are extended. Part of it is that the university will be closed till at least May 19th and all events are cancelled till the 1st of September. That includes, of course, the Eureka Week. A few weeks ago, you were quite confident that a normal, an ordinary week would be possible. I don't think that is. Or would you disagree with that?
No, I agree with you, Tessa. First of all, there will be a Eureka Week. And that will be the opening of the academic year. But of course, in form, it will differ. It will be more digital. But what I've seen, and next week we know more about it, it will be still very promising, creative, and attractive for students to attend the week. So no doubt about that. And of course, we were disappointed about the decision, but we can do understand it because I read the advice of the medical crisis team of the Netherlands, and I can understand that it's more first safe instead of sorry afterwards. Yes.
And were you disappointed as chair of the executive board, or were you also perhaps personally a bit disappointed?
I think both, sure, because you want here on the campus a little bit more seeing students and employees. But also in private life, of course, you want to get out, etc., etc. So, of course.
Yes, and Marijke, as I already said while introducing you, you are part of this committee looking into this, well, perhaps brighter future for the campus, a campus where we can perhaps come back, but we will have to keep our distance. How will this campus life look like, do you think?
Well, of course, less crowded. We are still looking into this 1.5 meter distance society, but you can imagine that like on a normal sunny day, it's crowded and everywhere there are people sitting and enjoying the sun. Well, you will be able to do that, but in a more distance from each other. And you can imagine that with not all the capacity that can be used in office spaces or classrooms, not everybody will be able to come to the university at the same time.
If we look at, for example, a lecture room, how many seats will go lost because we have to keep our distance?
Well, we already look into that. And for example, in the aula at this moment, with a normal capacity, 900 people, 900 students can sit there. But with 1.5 meter distance, the capacity is reduced to, let's say, 130 students. And for example, a lecture room in the Mandeville building of 75 people is reduced to, let's say, a 15 student capacity. So a big reduction of capacity of the, for example, the aula or lecture rooms.
And if we look at something completely different, the food plaza, there are all kinds of restaurants there, and there can sit a few hundred people perhaps.
Well, you can imagine that for like the Starbucks or the Jack Beans, the 1.5 meter distance, it's the same as you do right now in the supermarket at the cash register. Some lines are drawn on the floor to keep your 1.5 meter distance. But you can imagine that in the middle of the food plaza where everybody comes together, if you want to keep your distance over there, you also have to lower the capacity of the amount of people that come into the food plaza. And we are still working on that, how to manage that and how to regulate that. That's something we are working out right now.
And what is perhaps the most challenging part of, well, all of these kind of different things you have to look into?
You have to Indeed, you have to think about a lot of different things. But if we want to come to campus, most of us use public transport. And that's one of the still, well, main issues, the capacity of the public transport. But if you are here and maybe on your bike or another way, then there are some other challenges, like I already said, the capacity of the classrooms and, for example, the aula, but also the way of you, the capacity of the MBA hall for exams is also drastically reduced, but also the office spaces, how are we going to use them? Think, for example, about the elevator and the capacity if you want to go up to in Tinbergen to the highest floor or Mandeville. I can imagine that you don't want to use the stair, but you do want to use the elevator. And we're working on that, how to use them and how to use them in a safe way.
Yeah, thank you. So you say actually everything is difficult because it's so much. Hans, if you hear all this, do you see an bright future for the new start of the academic year? Will it be as usual or will it be different?
Well, you have understood from Marijke that it will be different, definitely. But I think that next week we will start communication. And that communication has one very important message. And that is that every student who starts here in September, as bachelor, master, no matter when, we guarantee, if they have successful exams, that they can get a degree or a diploma, no matter how. But it will be different. It will be a combination of being on the campus, but not always, and being online. It will be blended. But if the students do their best, and thanks to all the efforts of our employees, we can guarantee education. So, and that's important to communicate, but it's now the moment that students will subscribe in our university. And that message we will communicate next week. So the future will be bright, but it will be a different future. But they get the diplomas, we will educate them with the quality which is needed.
And on that note, what would you like to say to Dutch politician Jesse Klaver, who said in a debate yesterday that students in higher education don't get any education at all at the moment?
Well, I learned from that we should invite members of parliament as soon as possible to visit our university, all universities, but this university, the Erasmus University, to explain and to show them what we have done the last months to make it possible that students do not have much delay and get their diploma at the end of this academic year. He already corrected his statement, but we will invite all members of parliament who are responsible for education.
Yes, and we will send them our episode on workloads. Thank you all for watching. This was it for today. We'll be back on Tuesday, because Monday is, of course, King's Day, and we'll be celebrating it from home. Are you going to sing the national anthem outside on your balcony of garden?
Well, we have a balcony, but definitely we're going to stay on the balcony. Yeah. Definitely, because it's very special. Yes.
Well, if you're near, perhaps you can hear Hans singing. Thank you all for watching.